everybody, it's Sally Cathcart here and welcome to another Tuesday Teaching Tips. Now, I don't know about you, but quite a few of my students in my teaching studio are getting very excited about the idea of learning some Christmas songs and Christmas carols in the run-up to Christmas. And indeed, I think it's an important part of their year that they get really excited about playing these songs that everybody knows. But I hear from a lot of teachers who say, yes, but what do I do, Sally, with beginners who can't yet really read or play very much at all? In fact, their enthusiasm is often completely outweighed, usually outweighed, by their lack of technical skill and their lack of reading skill. What do I do with them? Because I still want them to experience, you know, the joy of the Christmas carol effect, as I like to call it. Well, there's been a lot of talk about this actually over in our community, in our Curiosity Lounge, and it's something quite dear to my heart, because what I love doing is creating what I call Christmas stories or Christmas sound stories. I take a picture book and a Christmas picture book, and I usually really enjoy going into Blackwell's in Oxford, and of course I haven't been able to this year, and choosing a new book, and choosing a book for the richness of how I can bring it to life musically, pianistically, without being too hampered by notation or anything like that. So books I've done in the past, the very first one, actually you can see up here, Santa, you mustn't wake the children. And we explore the piano, we have Santa going bumpity 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 bump down the piano. We have a little cat who meows and we make that sound on the piano. It's just wonderful when you see the children's faces because they get completely engaged. And of course it's a lovely way to introduce them to the different sounds the piano can make. The most popular piece though, the most popular sound story, is one called Susie Goose and the Christmas Star. And I think you can probably just see it down here. And this is a beautiful picture book, really beautiful. And it tells the story of Susie Goose and how she wants to go and reach the Christmas Star, and of course she doesn't quite get there. And I created a workbook to go with this for our community, and there's always a lot of excitement about how to make that really work, and it includes, of course, it's got a star, beautiful, we can play Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, and what child? And of course we're looking at beginners here, we're looking at primary age beginners, 5 to 8 I would say, what child doesn't love picking out the tune of Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, even with one finger, you know, they can usually do that. It's fairly stepwise, a little bit of help maybe getting the big leaps, but it's lovely to see their face. And of course for children, this is something they can share at home. You can get parents involved in helping to tell the story. You can get the child to do a performance of it, get them to video it, and then this Christmas they can share it with grandparents or other relatives who knows whether they're going to be able to see them or not. Certainly if they live in a different country, there's probably not a chance. So this is a lovely way of that child sharing something that they've been really enjoying and really appreciating over the course of the last few months. So this I love doing. It takes a little bit of thinking, I have to say. And I know that it takes a bit of time for me to put these things together. And I know teachers are always, we know that teachers are really short of time to create these sorts of resources. So this Friday, we're having a Sparkling Friday over here on the Curious Piano Teachers. And if you want to get hold of the workbook to go with Susie Goose so that you can bring your beginner piano lessons to life, then do look out on social media, because we're going to be giving away the workbooks to go with the story here. You still have to buy the book separately, but we're giving away the piano workbooks to go with the story, and that will be on our social media on Friday, so do look out for that. In the meantime, go and have a look at what storybooks you've got. Ask the child to find some storybooks if you like, and see how you can bring those to life to create Christmas sound stories with your beginners. Thank you all so much for watching, all of you that are out there, many thanks. And wherever you are in the world, whatever you're doing this afternoon, this morning, wherever, happy teaching. Take care. Bye for now.